Hey everybody, God, I'm so busy I can't even watch it, but I get ideas when I see things in the vault. Greenleaf Studios, super nice guy, super cool. Lucky guy gets to hang out with the Mini Wargaming crew. How cool is that? And he did a show in the vault that was titled, I believe, How to Do Barbed Wire. And I had gotten this like a year or two ago. What you're seeing is just tinsel here. This stuff is so cheap, it doesn't have a title. They're too cheap to put the word tinsel on here. However, I can see that it was made in Taiwan, and that it's from the craft factory, item number. Let's see if I can get the item number for you. 33511, and it's an ounce of literally tinsel. Now, when I picked this up, like I said, it was like $1.19. I'm like, that looks a lot like a bag of barbed wire, doesn't it? And then I thought, well, you know, it's probably pretty cheesy and it'll probably break. But this stuff, I mean, you can't floss with it and it will stretch a little bit. You know, and then the sparklies aren't quite as close together. See, I got a black shirt on. I wish I could say I was smart enough to say I did that on purpose. It's just dumb luck. I get more dumb luck situations on my show than anybody I know. But anyways, pardon me. But against my black shirt, you can kind of see that it looks very barbed wire-ish. Okay? Quite shiny. Okay, so, seeing what he did, and when I was looking for something else, I ran across this, and I'm like, you know what? That's a perfect how-to. So I'm going to do my own little how-to, but all the credit goes to, like I said, Greenleaf. He was the guy that did the how-to video. So he inspired me. Hopefully I can inspire others. Go check him out. Definitely subscribe to the guy. Super nice. Very responsive to his viewers on the show. Just full of excellent knowledge. I don't know what's in the water up in Canada up there, but those guys are really, they're world-class guys. Their scale model guys are fantastic. Their terrain guys are fantastic. And this is going to probably get me in a whole bunch of... I can't think of any painters off the top of my head, but I bet you there's a bunch of excellent painters up there as well. So, what I did was I went on my saw, and I just got some scrap, like that big, right behind that seat there. See that? That's full of scrap. So I took out a couple of chunks, and I set my saw for, I think, about a quarter inch, and then I ripped them, and then I set it for a half an inch, and then I just cut them into bricks. Now, why did I do that? I did that because I don't have anything to anchor my... So sorry, guys, here. I would never survive video school. They would have thrown me out years ago. Anyways, just hot glued all these guys together. The reason I did this is two things. One is cover, which is not the real reason, but it does give the impression of cover for your models on the battlefield. It also gives the impression that they're building amongst ruins. But most importantly, and I'll even get the item that is important here, are these toothpicks. They're a little over 2 inches, and I wanted them to look war-torn. So how do you make them look war-torn? Simply take them like this, find about the halfway point, and they're going to break at different lengths. You see how they're all broken at different lengths? And that's what I want. And then the next thing you do is you go through, and any long, hairy pieces that are going to peel off and give you that bright wood underneath that I'm not going to want later on, you want to take care of those now. You just kind of just grab them, pick them, pull them, basically give them a rough time, because your brush will probably not be as rough on them as your fingers. Try not to give yourself a sliver while doing this. But if you come in from the side and you just wiggle and tear, you're going to get nice broken ends, which gives it that, you know, grab a bunch of sticks from the wreckage kind of thing. And so this is what I'm going to do. I'll show you them really quick. Okay. And here are the tips. The tips are all just chewed up exactly how I want it, and they're all different lengths. This is the set that I made for this particular how-to. And it never hurts having extra bits around that you can sprinkle on your bases here. I'll bring these bases back a little bit into the picture so you can see. So what I got is I got a couple of different lengths and a machine gun nest. And it also helps to have things staged out. So if you look at it, this group goes to this one, this group goes to the long one, then short, 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 short. Okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these pieces here and I'm going to glue them onto my brick walls, because my brick walls are going to act as the anchoring point. And you want these, you don't want them, how should I say this? You want them to look rushed. So I'm specifically going to put them in at really weird angles. Like, see that really weird angle I got it at? I want it to look like a guy just grabbed a stick and started driving in with his rifle butt. I don't want it to look nice, pristine. I want it to look quick and desperate. The other aspect is that they don't have to be on the same side of the wall. You can do them all as the inside of the wall if you want, but you certainly don't have to. So I've got these two pieces right here on this. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quick glue these down here. And I glued these bases, the sand on these bases, real quick like. So I apologize if the sand is not cured. Normally I give these a lot more time to dry, and like I said, I'm a slave to my inspiration, and so I run with it, and I run quick with it. So this, here, let me bring you over here. So that's an example of a really quick base for these to go on to. So I'm going to real quick run down all these guys, and then we'll see what they look like. Okay, so I got one done. And you want some random rubble too. So whatever individual bricks I didn't have at the end, you know, you want to put them at a weird angle. Maybe out by themselves, whatever it is you want to do. Maybe I should put those there, probably look a little bit better, so you guys can see it. Something to look at while I'm dithering around here. And if you're worried about not getting the sticks the right length, you know, like they might not be making it to the ground, or they've gone too far and now you've got this little ugly problem you got to solve. You can also do all of your bricks down, which is what I'm going to do. It's just because it's faster. And I don't want you guys to get uninterested in what's going on. You know, try and keep it I do my best to try and keep it interesting, and I'm really lucky because there's a lot of people out there that are very, very understanding. You know, particularly the funny thing is other artists, because other artists know, you know, how fast this can, or I mean how slow this can go. But I want to thank everybody that came to the vault. There was one thing that was really interesting to me, because I wasn't expecting it. Probably 99% of the questions I get is from, you know, fellow guy hobbyists that are doing things. And a guy's girlfriend came on there and was asking questions about what she could do to help him with his modeling. And I was like, that is so cool. It's like I got, you know, like I was so lucky when I married my wife, guys, because she, you know, like I said, she'll call me up at work, say, hey, you know, they got these, you know, they got this Kickstarter going, and I thought that the figures were really cool, and I thought you'd like them, so I just got them for you. I'm like, wow, you know, that is just phenomenal. So whoever that guy is, you know, take her out to dinner. So that was really, really neat. I love to see wives and girlfriends get behind their boyfriends or husbands in the gaming, because so often it's like, I don't know, you feel like you're kind of a fifth wheel when you're doing it. It's like, you know, I've had girls where it's like, you know, it's more like they're putting up with you doing what you love, you know. Not a lot of them get behind and are supportive, and so, you know, hats off to whoever that was. You're a lady with a lot of class, and a lot of guys are very, very appreciative when the wives get involved. That's one of the cool things, like with Real Mithril, their whole family gets into it, and I love that. You don't see a lot of family type, unless it's like a vacation, and then it's more of an event. It's not so much, you know what I mean? It's not, let me go like here, you know. You know, unless they're on vacation, and usually then, okay, everybody's on their iPod or iPhone, or they're on, you know, a laptop. You know, I'm certainly guilty of that, but it's really slick to see good old-fashioned values, you know, actually being practiced. I think that is so incredibly awesome. So I've gotten all of my, kind of angled it for your viewing pleasure, I've got them all down. I got them high enough that they'll support the sticks, but not so high that you know, it'll enter. And you can totally, I just didn't cut out enough. You can have half of this wall and then just a post over here and then have barbed wire. That's fine. But like I said, I did it kind of quick, because I'm waiting on stuff to dry, and I thought a how-to would be really nice. So that's what I'm doing here. And these don't have to be on super strong, guys, because it's kind of a size to weight ratio when you build terrain. The bigger and the heavier the terrain is, The beefier you want your weak points to be, because they're going to get beat up and knocked around and things like that. When it's small and light like this is, it's not as big of a deal. And so that's my point of view on that. You're gonna have a million little spider webby things here, guys. So don't let that concern you. So it might actually be a little bit too long in the tooth. So because it's a little bit long in the tooth, I'll put it on this over here. Come on, play nice. Boy, they put people away for like talking to inanimate objects. You guys would never see me. Okay, here we go. All right. Now in some areas you're gonna wanna have it a little bit taller, just because you broke up your pattern a little bit and you want to accentuate that extra work you've put into it. And like this one is a little bit longer than the other guys, so I put three rows of bricks on it, and so I'm running okay. And sometimes you can get a little bit of artificial strength that you weren't even planning on having. I've got a little bit of a crack in between that brick there. And so I'm going to, with my hot glue gun, I'm going to try and jam it in there. And I might say unsuccessfully. Yep, that was definitely unsuccessful. Let's try that again. Also, if you have the setting on low, you gotta remember this cools down fairly quickly. So there we go. There we go. I'll have some leftovers, which is fine, because you can lay them across the ground and do all sorts of stuff with it. Jam that up there. Okay. Go. This one we'll do a couple extra here. Now this one, because it's my heavy weapons post or point, I want to accentuate it, so I'm going to grab the longer ones. There we go. Okay, almost done here. Well, got my first sand. So that's from it. I don't know if you can see the white there, right there. So what I'm gonna do is, if you make a mistake like this, it's really easy because the glue is still wet. If it moved, it's still wet. So you just go and you take a pinch of sand and you put it over that, you press it in and you turn it back over, and like a magic trick, it disappears, which is exactly what you want. Okay. There's that. What's the longest one I've got? Looks like it's even with you, and you've got an uglier end, which means you win. Okay. All right, so here we go. Actually, I'm gonna take a couple of these sticks now. Actually, it'd be easier to paint them individually. Sometimes it's easier to keep your stuff kind of off the painted on the sprue, so to speak. This is one of those situations. So I'm gonna just make a real rough looking situation here. We'll go like so. Make actually two heavy weapons points. Just one of them happens to be open ground and the other one happens to be with a base around it. So here is a ruined barbed wire emplacement without the barbed wire gun line. Looks to be about roughly a foot across. And can probably act as its own footprint. So now we're going to move on to how I would go about doing this. First of all, I won't glue anything here, but what I want to do is I want to show you what you would want to do. Okay? Let's go with a piece like this first. I'd have everything painted up already, everything done. Then what I would do. So I would take a dot of super glue, which I do not have. So what I'm going to try and do is I'm going to try and tie this. I don't know if that's going to work. Maybe a dot of super glue. Maybe I've got some super glue around. Hold on one second, guys. If I got some super glue here, I usually have it laying around. And I'm not going to have it. I'm not going to luck out. Okay, not a problem. Okay, I guess I can kind of show off how fast this Alain's glue really dries. All I need is a scrap piece of paper. I'm going to take some of this stuff, squirt it out. Yeah, you will be amazed at this stuff. If this works, since I've had it work like this before. Put just a little itty bitty dab. See a little itty bitty dab. Okay, now I'm going to take my tweezers. I'm just going to use the back of the tweezers and I'm going to just press it on, and of course it sticks to that. Now I think this is going to require super glue. Okay guys, I'm going to run upstairs and I'm going to grab some super glue. I'll probably be gone for only about 30 seconds because I'm almost positive I know where it is. So be right back. Listen to cool music. Found it. Voila, super glue. Okay. So now break the seal. Hopefully I can get it out. I'm gonna get rid of this piece of paper. And I'm gonna get a different piece of paper. Okay, so what I want to do. Is make sure the opening is clear. I'm sure it's going to come out in like gobs. Wish I had a needle handy to clear this. That's one of the problems with live shows, guys. It's hard to anticipate everything you're going to need. Alright, so I'm going to put this up to the light. And it is not coming out. So I will nip the top. And here we go. Thank you. All right. So I want a hot glue, I want to super glue that. And if it's going to be a problem, just nip it. So I've got that down there on that dot. Come on, cure baby. You know you wanna. Nope, but I can super glue my fingers together. Alright, are you actually holding? Okay. You appear to be holding. It seems like if you can tie a loop, and I'll try and do this, if you can tie a loop in the tinsel and then get it over a stick. Now the problem is that the tinsel is twisted. That's how you get all the detail. Okay, that actually worked out really well. Okay. And then here, I'm gonna go around low. I'm gonna actually go underneath. I got some extras there, but here, let's lay it down so you guys can see what's going on here. Should put a black background on it. But do you see that? That's one little hunk of tinsel. And it actually picks up really nice. Do I have anything black? It's hard to see it necessarily without a dark background. But you see that? Pretty cool, huh? It's very thin, so it actually looks like real barbed wire. It's not really thick and beefy. But that's how I do it. Oh my god, this is like 30 minutes. So that is my quick how-to that wasn't so quick. So, take care. Love you guys. Bye-bye.